Alright, so first lizard of the day. It's pretty much the most common lizard that you can find. It's a side blotched lizard. These guys are go to about 4 to 6 inches or so. In order to catch this guy, pretty much had to go into some thorny bushes and got my hands all stuck with thorns and stuff, but totally worth it. First lizard of the day. It's kind of weird. It's about probably 75, 80 degrees, warming up in the morning. This was the first one I've seen. I've been hiking for a couple miles, so definitely a little strange. I thought I'd see more stuff out here, but these guys, there he goes. She's, see if I can get her back. She is very, very squirmy, and she's got a big belly, and so that's why. She's, she's got, a bunch of eggs, or a bunch of babies in her anyway. These guys are pretty much insectivorous. They're a little lizard, so they're preyed upon by other lizards, snakes, birds, pretty much anything that can get a hold of this guy will take them out. But as I was saying, they're called a side blotch lizard because they do have a little black spot on their side there. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. I'm trying to focus it in there. But she's definitely really wiry because she's got a belly full of eggs. She'll end up digging in the sand and burying the eggs in there, and hopefully one of those will end up surviving to reach maturity. So I'll let her go, and we'll see if we can get some more. Run, little. Alright, so the thing that I've noticed about a lot of these animals out here is, you know, they've really learned how to survive in a harsh environment, you know, both with the weather, you know, the elements, but just also, you know, not being eaten. And a lot of the stuff out here, I mean, it's just really, really fast. Goes down holes really fast, they're really smart. You know, you got the whiptails, the zebra tails, the desert iguanas, but I ended up catching desert iguana here. So here he is. And it took me a little bit of time. These guys are pretty placid. And, you know, these guys will grow to about 10 or 16 inches if you include the tail. Got long old nails back here. But, you know, these are really cool animals, and he's breathing pretty hard, so he's definitely scared, but I'm not gonna hurt you, buddy. I'm gonna let you go right back where you're at. These guys are strictly herbivores. They won't really eat too many insects. They pretty much will be on the plant life, hence their name, iguana. They're pretty much diurnal. These guys can be found out when the temperatures are close to 110, 120 degrees, and most animals won't be out at that time. It kill most animals. These guys can typically be found out in the heat like that. They're pretty fast, they'll definitely seek the burrows if it gets too hot. So desert iguana. There's another iguana species out here, the chuckwall. That's part of the rock iguana family. Hopefully I can catch one of those. You guys take good snapshots. Alright, finally caught a whiptail. For the one that I caught, I lost about, 25 other ones. They are very, very clever, very fast. They know how close they can get to you or how close it'll allow you to get to them before they take off and run, and they seem to know where the holes are at, and they go down the holes. Thanks, buddy, for letting me catch you. Isn't he awesome looking? I mean, this is a cool looking lizard, built for this environment. Got some long old claws, very long tail. Stay out of the camera. I mean, this is a very, very cool lizard. They're diurnal. Trying to catch my breath. Basically, he ended up going up underneath some of these rocks and ended up being able to get them that way. Ended up going up underneath the rocks, and I basically pried the rock up and was able to quickly grab him. Alright, so some quick facts on the whiptail lizard is, if you include the tail, they can grow up in over a foot of length. Like I said before, they are diurnal. Very, very quick lizard. They're very tough to approach. These guys are mostly insectivorous. They'll eat, ants and beetles and grasshoppers and stuff that they can overpower. But these guys will occasionally eat other lizards as well. Maybe little side blotched lizards or other, smaller baby lizards, maybe western fence lizards, stuff like that. So I'm going to let this guy go here in just a second. I'll give you an idea of how quick these whiptail lizards are. Okay, so I'm going to let this guy go. I'll give you an idea of how quick they are. Zoom out here. All right, ready? There you go, go. All right, I'm out on just after sunset, night herping here on the road. Make sure no cars are coming here. Ended up running into this guy. Let's see if I can get him out of here.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
This is a long-nosed snake. Let's see if I can zoom in on here. They grow to about a foot to 2.5 feet. They're primarily nocturnal. And their defense is to basically twist their tail like they're a rattlesnake, and they will also spew out blood and musk, which he did right away as soon as I got him. That's okay. I wasn't sure what I was gonna do to him, so now he's flicking his fork tongue, trying to pick me up, trying to scent stuff. These guys will feed on lizards. They're an egg layer. Pretty much all the snakes are egg layers except for the rattlesnakes. These guys are pretty much only found in the desert regions. So, this is my first long-nosed snake. Definitely a cool experience here. Getting the first look at the long-nosed snake. Alright, here's another long-nosed snake. Guy's about a foot and a half, so he's pretty much an adult. I know it's not the same one because it's a different part of roadway. I'll help him get across the road here and make sure he doesn't get ran over. So it must be long-nosed snake night or something.